somebody asked him, you know, what is the significance of rain in your films? You know, because in each and every one of his films, there would be rain beautifully used. And he was in despair. He says, there's no significance. When I was young, I grew up, you know, I grew up with the rain. I used to love the rain. And sure, I mean, it finds its way aesthetically into his films, but there's no symbolic other meaning. So in that sense, there's no hidden meaning. But your point that it's extremely subtle is very true. I mean, every single thing about it is subtle.
Going back to what you were saying about editing, I'm just wondering, so do you think he had an end in mind? Or do you think he had the next scenes in mind? Or he didn't?
He clearly knew the episodes that he wanted to do, right? He knew there would be the printing press episode, and he knew there would be the slaughtering, the cockerel episode. I mean, every single episode, you know, the house collapsing. Every single episode, the war. Maybe he knew that he would actually end going back into the forest where the grandmother is leading the children off. Maybe he knew that. I have no way of knowing. But this much I know is that they really struggled with what goes where. And so there was no sticking to a script in that sense. In this case, what Tarkovsky says about the narrator is that at least at the end, he feels some torment in his soul. I'm almost quoting from the book, because he knows that he couldn't love the people around him well enough. So you're very, very perceptively said that he ends, actually he is left with that torment, you know. And in the end, I feel, you know, there is tremendous amount of yearning. He's left with a tremendous amount of yearning for, you know, for that home of his childhood, for that strong grandmother leading those, you know, the image of that, and also for the love which is there with his parents, when, you know, do you want a boy or a girl? You know, so very, very strong, positive, and beautiful memories, you know, almost like a yearning for that which may have been or may not even have been, it may even be in his mind.